was thinking, John, as well. I mean, if you look at Everton last season, I know obviously it's a slightly lower scale considering not a regular Champions League club, but they're quite stagnant before Christmas. Then they brought in Jelovic, and because he's a player kind of approaching his prime, and it kind of, you know, at that stage of his career, it immediately kind of changed the whole momentum and mood around the team. And sometimes it's often as if Wenger's trying to be a little bit too clever about his signings, that if they did sign that kind of player with that status, with that who can do it right now, it could just kind of alter the mood maybe. I mean, because sometimes a little bit of speculation to accumulate is worth it.
Yeah, no, I totally agree with Miguel. I mean, it was interesting, wasn't it, that basically, I think with Jelovic, he just gave everyone a lift to Everton. Yeah. And he inspired their second half of the season. It was a fantastic sort of thing, and you know, penal, I think, a little bit as well. And it's interesting, really, how players can give you that lift and boost in the dressing room, even though, you know, it might not be the player that you need or you're looking for long term. I just think sometimes it kind of gets you across that line. The one that I always think about is Jose Antonio Reyes. He came in sort of midway through the Invincible season, and he's dismissed as a disaster, but I just don't see it like that at all. Mm. I actually think that in there was a really good player who kind of gave Arsenal a lift and a bit of a turbo boost to go and fire them on towards winning the title. And so, therefore, he did his job, you know. And Walcott did the same in 2006. Diaby was signed in that summer. Adebayor, admittedly, took a little while longer to settle. But when he did, he really got going. So I do think that Arsenal have a little bit. I mean, Arshavin came in, and I think he did quite a good job that calendar, that season, 2009-2010. Arsenal do go and buy January deals, but it seems to me the more people that tell Arsene Wenger that he should go and sign, the more stubborn he is, and the more he fights against it, to be honest. It really is frustrating, I think.
Grossi, where do you think Arsenal will finish? That's the big question now starting to crystallise itself in the minds of many people. Spurs still in that top four. Arsenal losing yesterday. They've got just one game in hand. Are you worried? Are Arsenal fans now starting to be genuinely worried, and you're a fan, that they'll that they won't finish in the top four?
Yeah, I think, Darren, and listen, you see a bit more Spurs than I do, really, but every time, when I saw them on Saturday, and I just feel that they're a little bit methodical under AVB, much more sort of methodical than they were under Harry Redknapp, when they were sort of really exciting and sort of going forward. And yet, they found a consistency that I think that we'll see them finish fourth, because I just think that they might not have their sort of the Modric is now Van der Vaart to provide that kind of spectacular thing, but I just think they've got a consistency, and I don't think Arsenal have got the strength and depth they need. I mean, listen, if Arsenal sign a really good player in January, that might all change, but as it stands, I really think that Arsenal will finish fifth at the end of the season, because I just don't think they're good enough, really, the current squad, to maintain the top four. And I think they'll be squeezed out, and I think Spurs under AVB will get their wish, and I think they'll finish fourth, which will be a great return.
Well, let's ask it to our viewers watching the show at Sports Night TV. Will Arsenal finish in the top four, or will Spurs finally take North London and take that top four place in the Champions League?